I picked up this Kids Trax Viper, two-seater, doors open on it. We've got the pedal. See under there? It's already got a steel chassis. Yeah, so it's time for modifications. A donor car. It's a Mini Cooper S, it's only a single seater. I've got a link to that video. I'm gonna use the wheels. I'm gonna swap them for these, 4.10, 350, 3.50, 4-inch, 224-volt, 350-watt motors, belt-driven. Yeah, but I wanna keep the belt set up, lathed to 10 mil. Bearings have an inside diameter of 10 mil. Fits on there like that. The front spindle, I've got that modified too, shaved down to 10 mil to take the front wheels as well. I'll strip down this one here and we'll get all the bits and pieces. So we've got this Motion Dynamics speed controller. This one's got the regen braking on it. So we're going to use this. They're a good speed controller. Like, I like to use these because we don't have to put a mechanical brake on there. And just minimizes the build time. Yeah, your Hall Effect pedal. You got your positive, your negative, and then your control line here. 50 amp speed controller. I've used them in quite a few of the rides. These motors are belt drives, both of these. So obviously when you wire them up, one's going forward and one's going in reverse. So these are bi-directional motors. You get like a bit of 20 mil tube, and then you use these plates here. Put some longer bolts there, and then all you basically do is you use a BMX bike or a push bike setup, and you tension it up this way. So you just wind these nuts up, and don't have these too tight, and then that'll slide your motor back. The wheel will be in the front there, and then that'll put some tension on the belt. I've used them and they work, and you don't have to use no welding's involved in the framework. You know, obviously you bolt these through the body. Now these wheels were off a Chinese 49cc ATV. The wheels were the front wheels, have a disc brake on there, and I've just basically mounted the belt sprocket to the disc. I reckon the motor will probably sit up here somewhere, so I'm gonna probably have to make some extension on this. I'll try and minimize any cutting in here because it's sort of part of the structural integrity of the ride. If I did a live axle setup, then this one is a good setup because I'd be able to put the pillar block bearings on top of that. And then if I had a sprocket, it would probably run, you know, I'd have to slice in here and then have a motor. I'll probably put the motor in the back here, something like that. It's not enough room here for the motor, but until we have a muck around with it, and we'll work it all out. All right, bingo, well, that's gonna work. See, I've got enough thread through there. Yeah, bit of space there. We'll just make a little, you can see in here, I'll just make a little PVC pipe bush in there. I want to paint this white and then, yeah, change the tyre. I think it might be a pretty cool ride. We'll be right back. taken the seats off. So this is obviously the original 12 volt battery. Feel like an Anderson plug. A good little setup actually, because we'll probably keep the batteries in the underneath the seat, so we can fit one 12 volt there and another 12 volt there, making 24 volt. That's a little relay there. It's only good for 14 volt, so you wouldn't even really up volt these. You'd cook that. But saying that, you just do a rewiring of it if you want to go 18 volt or 24 volt. But still, I wouldn't recommend going any further than 18 volt on these things with these plastic gearboxes, because you'll end up having problems with welding the foot pedal together, and then you'll have a runaway ride. The motors, it's not a bad wiring harness. We'll keep that for something else. You flip it over and we'll have a look underneath and we'll see what we can do with these motors. What's a good way of fitting them? Probably put it there. That is made for it. There's a bit of adjustment there on this bar here. The hole's lined up, the sprocket's almost lined up. This is looking pretty good. Yeah, I think they look pretty cool. Yeah, I'm gonna paint these white. Should go alright with the blue. One front wheel. Alright, to the front end now. I'm going to muck around the steering, sort of. What I do like about this full metal frame is I don't have to build one, which on other rides I've had to, but I can see that this bar at the back is a bit flimsy to mount the motor to, so I'll go back to putting a 20mm square tube on there. I'll reinforce it, put a few bolts through that plastic, might even put a bit of checker plate on the inside, but I'll go with that line because the motor will sit on there fine. It gives me a bit of adjustment and it should line up with the sprocket. What I did discover was that spindle I made up didn't fit, so I've gone back to the donor car spindles. They are still sit a bit high, so I'm going to chop off about probably 20mm there, and that'll actually lower the front end. You can sort of see the bit of a gap in there with the guards. The front inner guard there can come down a bit, but apart from that, it's looking pretty cool. It's lower there, but I'm just gonna have to leave it there until I get back to it next Sunday, and I'll start having a look what else I gotta do. Obviously the batteries and speed controller wiring it up, but anyway, that's it. I'll see you on the next video.